वेलकम टू माय चैनल लाइफ साइंस विद निवेदिता। सो दिस वीडियो इज ऑल अबाउट जवाहरलाल नेहरू यूनिवर्सिटी एंट्रेंस एग्जाम, दैट इज जेएनयू एंट्रेंस एग्जाम 2021। सो एप्लीकेशन फॉर्म विल बी रिलीज्ड एंड फॉर कंडक्ट एंट्रेंस एग्जाम्स फॉर एडमिशन फॉर एमएससी, फॉर पीएचडी एंड ऑल्सो फेलोशिप इन हायर एजुकेशन इंस्टीट्यूट्स एज वेल। ओके, सो बिफोर स्टार्टिंग दिस सेशन आई वुड लाइक टू शेयर सम इन्फॉर्मेशन अबाउट जेएनयू। This JNU, that is Jawaharlal Nehru University, is a public central university which is located in the New Delhi, and it has a very academic excellence and securing second rank among all the universities. Okay, and it is top NAAC ranking, that is with A double plus grade, and also it was awarded the best university by the President of India in 2017. Okay, so this is some information about JNU. So now application will be released for many entrance exams. So here you can see over here. Here information bulletin. So here brochure will be provided, which is they will conduct. You know, each and everything is provided in this brochure itself. And also here, this is application form, that is public notice they have released. So if you want to apply, just go for just click on this link. I'll provide the link in the description. It will redirect to the website. Okay. So before applying for these examinations, you have to know about this exam, about the eligibility, and also about examination fee, each and everything, right? So okay, so started with the public notice. So once again, okay, see here, this is the public notice which will released on 27 July 2021 for JNU entrance exam. So here they will mention once again, okay, so the NTA will be conducting the JNU University entrance exam for admission to various courses offered at JNU University for the academic year 2021 to 2021. Okay, and this examination is CBT mode, that is computer based test. Okay, so and also when come to the duration of online registration and submission of online form will started from 27 of July, and the last date is 27 of August 2021 up to 5 p.m. okay, August 27 is the last date. And also last date to successful fee transaction. Okay, for the fee transaction, the last date is 27 August, that is up to 11:50 p.m. okay. And also when comes the date of examination, that examination was held on 20, 21, 22, 28 September. Okay, there are 4 dates they will be provided. And also duration of examination is 120 minutes, that is 3 hours. Okay, and mode of examination, that is CBT mode, computer based test. And also when comes the pattern of examination, this is multiple choice questions, okay, MCQs, and medium of paper is in the English language. Okay, other than language courses also there, the mainly is the, it is in the English language. And also among these, among all these information, the extra thing is there is no negative marking. Okay, in JNU entrance exam there is no negative marking is. So this is about this and public notice. So now move on to the eligibility criteria and all. So this is the brochure which is provided by the JNU, that is related to JNU entrance exam 2021 to 2022. Okay, so through this brochure they will give each and everything, they'll provide each and everything in all. So see, this is about the online submission of application form, as we already mentioned in the public notice, right, that thing. And this is about fee payment. Okay, fee payment and all they're provided. You see over here, these are the some courses, that is about international studies, language, literature and cultural studies, social studies, and also arts and arts, life sciences, environmental science, computer, each and everything they provided through this brochure. And also when come to the JNU entrance exam, this is an all India level, okay, all India level entrance exam, so which will connected in all over all cities throughout the India. Okay, and also when come to the, this is about scheme, that is a CBT mode, 3 hours, multiple choice questions, the number of questions is 100, and each question will carry 1 marks. And also the main thing, the main and plus point for about this examination is there is no negative marking for incorrect response, this incorrect answers, there is no negative marking. Okay, you see over here, there is each and everything they have mentioned about the photo, the size of the photo, signature, the size of the signature and all. And also the how to register, after the registration form, how to complete the application form, each and everything they will given in this brochure. Okay, just go through this. I'll provide the link of this brochure in the description, kindly check it out. Okay, and see, this is the fee payment, that is for PhD, MTech, MSc, MA, MCA and all. This is for your first year BSc, and then also MSc integrated course and all, the fees payment. So each and everything they will provide. Okay, and also so now you can see over here, these are the list of the centers. So when come to the Karnataka state, you can see over here, for the Karnataka states, there is Five centers are there. It is Bengaluru, Dharwad, Gulbarga, Mangaluru, and also Mysore. Okay, so these are the five centers for Karnataka. Okay, so now move on to the next thing. You can see over here, these all are the degree programs which are provided in this university. That is about School of International Studies, Language, Literature and Cultural Studies. So when come to the life sciences, you can see over here life sciences, right? And life sciences, PhD as well as MSc. So both these two are available for life science candidates. Okay. So apart from this, there are many courses are there. You can see over here, still many things are there. They are provided each and everything. It's about fee payment. Okay, fee payment mode also. They will provide it here. And yes, okay. See, now move on to the eligibility. Okay, so this is all about the eligibility of art subject. So this is about a PhD in the international studies. So we want life science, right? So just go for the life science course, that is life science eligibility and all. This is about language, literature and cultural studies. And this is Chinese, okay. So see here, now when one is School of Life Sciences, okay. So when come to the School of Life Sciences, that is eligibility for this MSc. This is eligibility for MSc, okay. For MSc, bachelor's science, that is BSc or BTech or equivalent in biological, physical or agricultural sciences or biotechnology under the pattern like 10 plus 2 plus 3, that is 10 SSLC and also 2 PUC. And three, your bachelor, that is undergraduate program, okay, with at least 55 marks, okay, 55 marks has to be scored to apply to this MSc, okay, and for MSc. When come to the PhD, there are many groups are there in PhD, it's 1, 2, 4, and 5. The first group, master degree or equivalent with 55% or equivalent grade B, it is under UGC 7-point scale, okay, and also this, which is coming under the followed subject are life sciences or biological, physical, or chemical and also agriculture, okay. And also when come to the group two, this is agricultural sciences and biotechnology, botany, zoology, bioinformatics, genetics, microbiology, system science and other branch of biological science or MBBS with 55% marks are equivalent, okay. So when come to the group four, this master degree in the field given above with the 55% or equivalent and obtained 2 years MPhil degree with at least 55 marks. Okay, here MPhil degrees obtained as equivalent marks. Okay, of a recognized university or institution with presentation, seminar or viva, or 1 year MPhil with 55% of marks with additional 1 year research experience. Okay, to apply for this PhD, MPhil or 1 year research experience is needed. Okay, and also when come to the SC, ST and OBC non-cream layer category and also PWD, the relaxation are there. Okay, so this is about the eligibility to apply the examination for JNU. You see over here, there are many courses apart from this life sciences. You can see this is a Master of Arts, which is about the public health, and also this is about information sector, labor studies, and here the ancient history, political science, economics, geography, modern history, and also about social science, social system. You can see there are many, plenty of courses are there. And also this is about environmental studies. And also this is about computer and system sciences. Okay. And here the physical sciences, and also here computational and integrative sciences courses also available. Physical, mathematical, chemical sciences courses also available. See, many, and so biotechnology courses also available. Okay, you can just go through this brochure. Each and everything they will mention, there are plenty of courses are there. There are plenty of courses will be offered for students. Okay, so this is about the JNU, about the entrance exam, and also about the eligibility and all. So if you are eligible, if you are interested to do PhD in this university, okay, just attempt this exam. And also the plus point is no negative marking, right? So even though no negative marking, you just have given attempt for this exam. So all the very best. Okay, and thank you so much for watching. I think I hope it's clear about this JNU entrance exam. So if any doubts, any queries, let me know in the comment box. Okay, so thank you so much for watching. Until next time, stay safe, stay healthy, keep learning.